Good morning. Welcome to Basic Electrical Engineering, Unit 3, Transformers, Lecture 16, Losses and Efficiency of Transformer. That is, today's topic is Losses and Efficiency of a Transformer. In an electrical machine, loss can be defined as the difference between input power and the output power. We are sending some input power and there is some output power, and output power is not equal to the input, that is, whatever is sent is not obtained at the output. That means there is some loss in between, that we call it as a loss. An electrical transformer is a static device, hence static in the sense it is stationary, unlike the rotating machines, motor and generator. Hence, mechanical losses like frictional and windage losses are absent in transformer. Now, the classification of the losses in a transformer. Basically, the losses in a transformer can be classified into four categories. Iron or core losses is the first one. Copper or ohmic losses is the second one. Stray losses, third one. Dielectric losses, fourth one. Now further, core losses can be, or iron losses can be classified as hysteresis and eddy current losses. Now what is the iron loss? First way, iron losses. These iron losses are generally caused in the core of the transformer. They are caused by the alternating flux in the core of the transformer. Because they are caused in the core of the transformer, these iron losses are also called core losses. And as we have discussed, iron losses are further classified into hysteresis and eddy current losses. So three things you have to remember. Iron losses are also known as copper losses because these are caused in the copper core of the transformer. And furthermore, it's divided into hysteresis and eddy current losses. What are hysteresis losses? The core of a transformer is subjected to an alternating magnetizing force. And for each cycle of EMF, a hysteresis loop is traced out. Power is dissipated in the form of heat, known as hysteresis loss, and given by the equation power loss due to hysteresis PH, power loss due to hysteresis K eta B max power 1.6 FV watts, where K eta is a proportionality constant which depends upon the volume and quality of the material, and F is the supply frequency. B max is the maximum flux density. The iron losses or core losses can be minimized using silicon steel material for construction of core of the transformer. That is, the hysteresis losses can be minimized by using silicon steel material because there is some power dissipated in the form of heat whenever there is the core is subjected to an alternating magnetizing force. Now this is what is, if you take a ferromagnetic material, in general the atoms are randomly placed. When a field is applied, they align themselves in a particular fashion. When it is removed, not all of them get distracted. Some will be still in the aligned position, and due to this there is some hysteresis, that is residual magnetism that is present, that is spontaneous magnetism or residual magnetism that is still existing even after removal of the external field. So eddy currents, when the flux links with the closed path, an EMF is induced in the circuit and current flows. The value of the current depends upon the amount of EMF around the circuit and the resistance of the circuit. Since core is made up of conducting material, this EMF circulates currents within the body of the material. Not only there will be EMF and current in the windings, there will also be in the core because the core is a conducting material. These circulating currents are called eddy currents. That means simply you can say core is also a conducting material because of which there will be some EMF and currents that are induced in the core which are not participating in the actual process of transformation or transformer principle. So these are called as eddy currents. It produces a loss I square R in the magnetic material, known as eddy current loss, which is given by eddy current loss PE, power loss by eddy current, is equal to KE BM B maximum square T square F square V. Previously we have seen hysteresis loss was proportional to frequency, but here eddy current losses are proportional to square of the frequency. That is the main difference that you have to observe. And also B square, there B power my 1.6. K is the coefficient of eddy current. Its value depends upon the nature of the magnetic material, like volume and resistivity. And B max is the maximum flux density. Units are Weber per meter square or Tesla. T is the thickness. It's a small t, sorry. And F is the frequency and V is the volume of the magnetic material that is used. So these are hysteresis and eddy currents. You can see there are some changing flux that is linking, and also because there is a current, there will be a flux linking with the coil, and because of this there are some eddy currents that are formed. These lines that represents eddy currents. So because of these eddy currents, there will be a power loss, and which is the loss of the one of the laws of the transformer, which is a part of iron losses. Now, eddy current versus hysteresis losses. Comparison chart. Now, definition. The loss occur because of the relative motion between the core and the magnetic flux, eddy currents. And this loss occur because of the reversal of magnetism in the, is known as hysteresis loss. Because we are applying magnetism, we are removing, that is, the magnetism is being reversed continuously. So, because of that, hysteresis losses occur. And formula, as we have seen, KVF square T square BM square KVF BM, where here V is not the voltage, V is the volume, and F is the frequency, T is the thickness, B is the maximum flux density. And how do they occur? Interaction of magnetic flux and conductor, and this is because of the reversal of flux. And minimizing method, by making the core of thin laminations. If you make very thin laminations, the power loss can be reduced. That is why there are laminations in the transformer in order to reduce the eddy currents. They are nothing but the slices of a bread, and by using a good grade material we can reduce the hysteresis loss. The method to reduce eddy current losses is laminating the core, and the method to reduce hysteresis loss is to use a good grade material, silicon steel materials. And now copper loss or ohmic losses. These are the losses occurred due to ohmic resistance of the transformer winding. That is, I1 and I2 are the primary and secondary currents, R1 and R2 are the resistance of the primary and secondary winding. That means generally any winding has some resistance in it, and because if there is a current flow, there is a voltage drop. So we say R1 is the resistance of the primary winding, R2 is the resistance of the secondary winding, and I1 is the current flowing in the primary winding, and I2 is the current flowing in the secondary winding. Now then, the copper losses occurring in the primary and secondary will be the losses in primary because of the resistance I1 square R1, because of the resistance R2, I2 square R2. Therefore, the total copper losses will be I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. I1 square R1 is the power loss or copper losses or ohmic losses in the primary. I2 square R2 is the copper losses in the secondary. These losses varied according to load, and hence it is known as variable losses. Copper losses vary as the square of the load current. These two points you have to remember. That is, according to the load, they vary, hence these are known as variable losses. Whereas the iron losses are known as the constant losses. Iron losses are also known as core losses and constant losses. Copper losses or ohmic losses are known as variable losses. And these are proportional to the square of the load current. Now, stray and dielectric losses, these are the last small part of the losses. Stray losses, the occurrence of these stray losses is due to the presence of leakage field. The percentage of these losses are very small, as I told you, as compared to the iron and copper losses, so they can be neglected because there will be some leakage field. In magnetic circuits, we have leakage flux that is coming out of the circuits and which enters into the air or any insulation material, which is very, very small, and the losses due to this are very small. And dielectric loss. Dielectric loss occurrence in the insulating material of the transformer, that is in the oil of the transformer. Generally, there is an oil that is present in the transformer, and there is some loss in this insulating material or in the solid insulation. When the oil gets deteriorated and the insulation gets damaged, its quality decreases and the efficiency of transformer get affected. So these are stray and dielectric. Stray losses are due to the presence of leakage field, and dielectric is the losses in the insulating material. Efficiency. After discussing losses, it's very important to discuss the efficiency, because output is nothing but input minus losses, or input is equal to output plus losses. If you are giving, let's say, 100 watts and the output is 80 watts, therefore the loss will be 20 watts. Therefore, 100 is equal to 80 plus 20. 100 is the input, 20 is the loss, and 80 is the output. So input is equal to output plus losses, or in other words, output is equal to input minus losses. So just like any other electrical machine, efficiency of a transformer can be defined as output divided by the input power. That is efficiency is equal to output by input power. Transformers are mostly highly efficient electrical devices. Most of the transformers have full load efficiency between 95 to 98.5%. This is a very important characteristic of a transformer. It is very efficient. Its efficiency is almost greater than 95 at full load. As a transformer being highly efficient, output and input are having nearly same value. That means because they are, if you get 95 or 98% efficiency, that means output and input are approximately of the same value. That means one, efficiency is 100% is nothing but output and input both are same. But if it's 98 and 95, we can say they are approximately equal. Output and input are having nearly same value. Hence, it is impractical to measure the efficiency of transformer by using output and input method. A better method to find efficiency of a transformer is using this. That is, efficiency is equal to input minus losses by input, or you take 1 minus losses by input. That means if you are taking input by input minus losses by input, that is input by input is 1 and losses by input is 1 minus losses by input. Or you can take the other way around, output by input and input is equal to output plus losses. Efficiency. Iron and copper losses are wasted as heat and temperature of the transformer raises. Therefore, output of the transformer will be always less than the input power drawn by the primary from the source, and efficiency is defined as efficiency is equal to output by input. Iron and copper losses are wasted as heat and temperature of the transformer raises. Output power of the transformer is always less than the input power. Input power is drawn from the source. So the efficiency is called output by input. Output in kVA by what is the input? Output power in kW plus kilowatts plus losses. What are the types of losses we have? Stray and dielectric. The other losses are neglected, dielectric losses. But the most important are losses are iron losses and copper losses. Output by output plus losses. Output plus losses is nothing but your input power. So output power by iron losses are constant losses. So PI plus copper losses are I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2, we have seen it. And input power is always equal to V1 I1 cos phi. Output power is equal to V2 I2 cos phi. So efficiency is equal to V2 I2 cos phi by V2 I2 cos phi plus PI plus I1 square R1 plus I2 square R2. This is the efficiency expression for transformer. What is the condition for maximum efficiency? When do we get maximum efficiency? That we have to find. So efficiency is equal to this expression we have seen, 1 minus losses by input, or input minus losses by input. 1 minus, what are the losses? I1 square R1 plus W1. So efficiency is equal to 1 minus I1 R1 by V1 cos phi 1 I1 square R1. Sorry, this is minus W1 by V1 I1 cos phi 1. So your I1 I1 gets cancelled. So this is, you get I1 R1 and V1 cos phi 1. So d theta by di1 is equal to 1 differentiation 0, and we are differentiating with respect to I1, so I1 differentiation is 1, so R1 by V1 plus cos phi 1 is constant, plus I1 is in the denominator, 1 by y, that is y power minus 1, differentiation is y power minus n into x power n minus 1, that is minus 1 into I1 power minus 1 minus 1, that is minus 2. That is W1 by V1 I1 square cos phi 1. You'll get plus here because minus 1, that is coming outside. So eta will be maximum at d eta by di1 is equal to 0. Because we have considered d theta by di1, I have taken only one losses and the other losses I've just neglected them. Hence efficiency will be maximum at R1 by V1 cos phi 1. This is when this term is equal to 0. That means W by V1 I1 square cos phi 1 is equal to R1 by V1 cos phi 1. So I1 square R1 is equal by V1 I1 square cos phi is equal to W by V1 I1 square cos phi. Multiplying and dividing the left side expression by I1 square. So denominator denominator gets cancelled. I1 square R1 is equal to W. That is, these are iron losses. WI is nothing but iron losses. I1 square R1 is the copper loss. So when iron losses is equal to copper losses, then the maximum efficiency will occur. This is the condition for maximum efficiency. When do we get the maximum efficiency of a transformer is when iron losses and copper losses are equal. Now, what is all day efficiency? The ratio of energy output of 24 hours to the energy input of 24 hour period is called as the all day efficiency of the transformer. So eta all day is equal to energy output over 24 hours by energy input over 24 hours is equal to energy output over 24 hours by energy output over 24 hours plus energy losses over 24 hours. Input is equal to output plus losses. If we could know the load of the transformer, all day efficiency can be easily determined. So this is all about the losses and the efficiency. And this is the end of the lecture. Lecture 16, Unit 3, Basic Electrical Engineering. Today we have seen what are losses and efficiency of a transformer. What are the different types of losses? Iron losses, copper losses, stray losses and dielectric losses. Also the classification of iron losses as hysteresis and eddy current losses. What are the methods to minimize these hysteresis and eddy current losses? And what are variable losses are nothing but copper losses, and constant losses are nothing but iron losses. And what is the efficiency expression, and what is the condition for maximum efficiency, and what is all day efficiency. This is all about the losses and efficiency of a transformer. Thank you.